landed in Anchorage. About to start our little adventure. We're looking for a few Dall sheep and grizzly bears.
What gave me life and took my breath away?
To load the plane here and head into the main base camp lodge, and then from there we'll keep flying out to the spot camp where we'll start hunting.
I heard I was a wild one, I feel like a child son, but I really don't recall. Heard I was a fast one, oh, this was the last one, waiting for the other shoe to fall. I've seen pictures and I've heard stories about the boy I used to be, but I don't remember me. Was I just another ghost in this town?
First legal hunting day today, so had a little bit of rain in the night, and it was raining a little bit this morning, but it's cleared for now, and we're gonna head up the valley here and see if we can get a look at those rams. We've seen them last night, so day three of the hunt, day two that we can actually hunt, and yesterday we got rained out in the afternoon, so couldn't get a good look at the ram, but I've spotted him again this morning. He's in a pretty good spot. We should be able to get within about 500 yards and get a good evaluation on him. So just started our climb.
Fast one, always was the last one, waiting for the other shoe to fall.
just making our way back down. Decided to pass that ramp, so gonna get moved to a different area this afternoon. So just gonna bust back to camp. Mid-morning, day four, our third day hunting. We got moved last night. Rob flew us to a new area, and we picked up four rams this morning up in the saddle. You can see in the distance, a couple look pretty nice, definitely worth a better look. Seen a couple different bunches of ewes and lambs, and we've seen four other young rams last night, so we will head in the direction of these ones and see what we come up with. It's the afternoon of day four, and we've got camp set up here. We made our way kind of down the valley a little bit, and then we've headed up, come up this draw, and rams are actually, where are we? Up here behind us over the saddles, up in behind here, so. We're in a bit of a tricky spot, so we're gonna kind of just get back and watch them this afternoon and see where they end up. If they make kind of their way down from where they are, we might be able to get a good look at them today. But you know, two of the rams are pretty nice. They're over full curl, and one looks to be pretty heavy and the other one looks to be quite long and flared out, so a couple definitely worth getting a closer look at, so yeah. See what the afternoon brings. Sitting around waiting for these rams to show back up. Past the time. Eat a few blueberries. Pretty damn good. So it's just after 2 o'clock, we've spotted the rams again, but they're still up in that safe zone, as we're calling it. Pretty much can't get at them from any angle, so they need to either move or, well, that's the only thing they can do really for us to have any luck, is they move and they need to come down, and then we can probably put a sneak on them. So yeah, lots of camps right in the blueberry patch, so these red bushes you can see up here, they're all blueberry bushes, so we got a pretty good chance at seeing a bear or two around in this area. We've seen a sow and cub last night and this morning, so definitely bears in the area. We do also have a grizzly tag, so we get the sheep done.
And I'm never very far from what I am. I was born country, and that's what I'll always be. Like the rivers and the woods.
Well, it's day five of the hunt. The fourth day of hunting. Packed up camp this morning. And we're gonna head up over that saddle there. Right there. That's where we last seen the rams go over there at 2 o'clock yesterday afternoon, so it's gonna be a bit of a climb.
And pretend I'm a shelter for heartaches that don't have a home. Choose the words the color.
Over 2.5 hours into the climb. Probably about 75 2 o'clock, the rams, well, the ram has gotten up and moved out of sight, so I'm just going to drop down here, drop some stuff out of our packs, and then climb up to where we last saw it go over. So.
Your love might be my damnation. I'll cry to my grave.
2:30, we just dropped a drop some felt gear. Gonna make the climb. Hopefully get up on here. Hopefully be able to see the rams. It's gonna be a bit of a crunch, he's pretty steep and it's loose shale, so hopefully we can get up there without making too much noise.
Ram down, buddy. Ram down, boys. Ram down.
Well, if something broke, we can find it.
3:22. Zach just got his Dall sheep. It's down on that scree slide there. We watched him go over that saddle at about 2 o'clock yesterday. Come up there this morning and spotted one ram down below our current position here. We dropped down through the saddle, dropped some gear, climbed up on this knoll and peeked over, and the rams were 160 yards. So we had ample time to judge them. There was two very nice rams in the band, so Zach had a hard decision to make, and he picked a nice flaring ram. So yeah, everyone's pretty happy. So gonna drop back down the way we came up, grab our gear, head down to the ram and take a look at them.
Well, take your time. Don't live too fast. Troubles will come. And they will pass. We'll find a
made it back to our cache and loaded up our gear, and now we're just sidling around to Zach's ram. You can see him, he's only about 150 yards away, so everyone's pretty excited to get their hands on him. Put your hands on, bud.
I'm afraid if I pick him up, he's gonna roll.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna.
If you try. Oh, what a beauty.
He wasn't easy. That makes him even more special.
Yeah.
Wow. That's just awesome.
Oh,
Easy.
I'm up.
How does it feel?
Heavy.
Only 5 miles to go. Just had to drop down into the bottom of the drainage where Zach got his ram and fill up the old water bottles. Didn't quite have enough to get us through the night and then back to the airstrip tomorrow, so. Just got back from getting some water. Now it's time to get a little supper in us. Fuel up for tomorrow. Here they go, up over there, through that saddle. And back down the other side to the airstrip. Where? Fry up some sheep steaks, hopefully. Climbing for about an hour. Camped halfway down that drawer, and we are about 30 yards from the top, so 5 more minutes we'll be there, and then she's all downhill from there. So this is the drainage. We got Zach's ram in yesterday. The 3 other rams that were with him are still down in here, and one is actually, almost seems like he's following us. He's a couple hundred yards. A couple hundred yards below us, but he's heading towards us. So we'll get a close encounter here with this ram the next little while. We've been gone for about 5.5 hours and a little rise to go here. And then we're kind of on a tundra plain, and yeah, airstrip's only a few hundred yards, so hopefully next 10 or 15 minutes we'll be jumping these packs. Last few minutes of the pack out. Camp is in sight, and it also means the airstrip, so about 5.75 hours to from where we camped last night to make it back here, so it'll be a relief. The three of us all have around 100-pound packs, so it's gonna be nice to take him off. Poor old Justin. I said poor old Justin, he's only 25 but he looks about 80. Hunched over.
He's got the heaviest pack, I believe. What a time to be alive. Flew back in last night, and this morning we dealt with the Cape and some of the meat, and a couple hours ago we slapped the hind quarter on the Traeger. So yeah, the smells coming out of this thing right now are unbelievable. So yeah, so the sheep hind quarter's been on there for about 10.5 hours now. It's reading about 145 in the center, so should be medium rare. Looks absolutely phenomenal. Can't wait to rip into it. So got an awesome message this morning that Zach got his grizzly. So I unfortunately got a bit sick a couple days ago and had to come back to the lodge, and unfortunately I lucked out and didn't have to ride the storm out in the tent. But yeah, that kind of puts the icing on the cake for this hunt in Alaska. So, hell of a sheep and a really nice bear. So, sheep meat on the Traeger is about the best wild game I've ever had. We roasted up that hind leg a couple days ago, and 10.5 hours to cook that, and that was phenomenal. Now last night we cooked up the ribs and had some other hunters in here in New Mexico, and they believed it. That was the best rib he's ever had. So unfortunately, sheep don't have more ribs, but yeah, that'll just have to get us out there looking for another one somewhere in the world. So just want to thank Rob Jones from R&R Guide Service. He was the outfitter that facilitated this hunt. Got an amazing crew here and a pretty awesome setup with his lodge here. Been outfitting here a long time, he knows the area well and had us on animals wherever he put us. So yeah, he just made the experience all that much better, and was a absolute pleasure hunting up here with them. So obviously couldn't have done it without my friend Zach for inviting me on this trip. When you get offered these opportunities, it's crazy to turn them down. So thanks again, man. I'm glad I came up here, I had a blast. Yeah, hopefully he can return the favor in New Zealand sometime. Well, take your time. Don't live too fast.